So, all of you, you are expected to have the classes right away. By yesterday onwards, you have 2-1 classes. So, it could be my first hour for you. And I am going to deal with you on Python programming. Okay, I am going to deal with you on Python programming. Then what is the importance of this Python programming and how this could be useful for you, and many programs which are used to write using Python programming will be going to discuss with you for forthcoming classes or forthcoming sessions. Today, I'd like to introduce you what is the Python programming and how the Python programming is and how it is being evaluated. So, and myself, I am Gopal Reddy. So, I am going to deal with you the Python programming for you for this particular semester. And importance of Python programming and its history, let us discuss. Today's class will be absolutely introduction only. I am supposed to give you very brief idea regarding to the Python emerging into the computer science world. Actually, Python was introduced by Guido von Rosum. So he is the person. So who introduced to this particular IT industry? So in 1989, he is working with National Research Institute at Netherlands. So thereby he was introduced. He was actually when he was a master's student in the sense MS student, Master of Science student. So he is taking the project as a compilation or interpreter kind of computer science project has been taken by him, and it was evaluated and continued in National Research Institute also. So actually he was started working in 1989, and actually originally it has been come into the picture. Originally it is coming to the picture. Officially it is available. Python is made available to the public on 20th February 1991. Python was having two versions of Python is there with Python. So first version is Python 2.0, and it was originally released in 16th October 2000, and this version is included cycle detection of garbage collector, Java also the garbage collector. You don't know about Java, but even then, please listen. If any variable has been created by you, memory allocation will be done by you, and that variable could not be destroyed by yourself while leaving that particular program, or scope of program is gets over, then that would be considered as garbage collection. That the value, whatever the value you have been stored within that particular variable, that could be available, and it could not be useful for any other program other than you. So because you have wrote your own program and you have used that particular variable for your purpose, before leaving your program, you haven't cleared that particular variable, so that for other programs, for other processes, that value could be considered as garbage. So that garbage collector will be continuously evaluated in Python 2.0, and it is also supported Unicode. Unicode also be supported here, so that because of Unicode support, so you may be connect as many number of devices using Python. You can connect a huge number of devices. So because of this Unicode facility, so you may be connect many number of devices, electronic devices such as AC, TV, TV remote, AC remote, XYZ, many number of things are there which are used to develop here. Okay, and second version is Python 3.0. Python 3.0 also available with us, and it was released 3rd December 2008. So what is the basic difference between these two is Python 2.0 is nowadays it is not available. Of course, the interpreter is available in the internet, but the people are not using Python 2.0. People are using only Python 3.0 right now. So what is the importance of this one is the built-in breakup points. If any problem is being going on, I mean, while we are trying to write any, let me talk about C programming. While we are trying to write any program in C, and if you want to check that that particular program will be executed in a proper way or not, for doing that one, so you may be perform debugging. Debugging in the sense, if you are supposed to use Turbo C in the sense of the blue colored screen C, then you may be operate F7 to execute each and every line by line execution could be done using C programming. So as and when if you want to identify some error, I mean semantic error, that is logical error will be there. So then those errors will be evaluated by taking the debugging option, otherwise by incorporating some breakpoints. Okay, if you consider that so somewhere else in the program, some 20th line of the program, you have some particular problem. So if you want to identify that point, then manually you have to open your code and you have to put one breakpoint over there, and then you have to execute. So that that could be execute up to that particular breakpoint, and thereby it could be executed line by line. So such kind of things, built-in breakpoints allocation could be there in Python 3.0. And the data classes will also be available. Customization of modules. You may be right. Probably you people haven't idea what is a module. But in our C programming, you have many number of functions, huge in number of functions, and a huge in number of what we call .h files also there with you. And those files will be gets included into your program, and you could able to run your operation. So such kind of header files or functions you could write at your own and you could use. So those things anywhere else within the Python program, not exactly that particular program, any other program, you can use your own module, what you wrote to that particular module, that could be so used there. So such kind of things are there. Type enhancements, normally in C, C++, Java, so if any variable can be used by you, that particular variable must be initialized, declared before going to use that particular variable. Declare in the sense, if you want to use any particular variable as integer, you must be declare something like this, integer sum x, something like this you have to declare, and then use this particular variable. But here in Python, declaration is not required. Directly you can use your variable, and based on the value what you are supposed to place within that particular so called variable, it could be identify its type in the sense whether it is integer or float value or character or string, whatever it may be. Okay, so such kind of type enhancements could also be included in our 3.0, and the timing precision could also be there. So this is actually related to graphical user interface development actually. So we will discuss about this particular point when time will becomes to us. Okay, so likewise we have Python 2.0 and Python 3.0. Nowadays people are using Python 3.0 only. Python 2.0 was not used. Okay, of course some projects are there in IT industry which were developed by Python 2.0. For those projects they are using Python 2.0 only. Right away from 2009 onwards, so people are using only Python 3.0 only. And nowadays people are developing any so project in IT industry using Python, that version must be so Python 3.0. And as we consider in India, so people are basic programming language for students will be C in India, but in other countries other than India, so people are learning Python as a basic programming language. Okay, in India yet to be decided, but in European Union or American Union or Arab Union, all those people in their colleges, they have used this Python as so beginner's programming language. Okay, and then he was selected the Python name from one serial which was broadcasted in BBC during 1969 to 1974. So that particular serial is the complete Monty Python circus. Okay, the complete Monty Python circus. From this particular serial, the name Python was taken, and it has been given that particular name. So that is the, he is a very big fan of BBC, British Broadcast Corporation TV, and he is always watching the news from that particular BBC and serials from BBC. So he was inspired. So this particular so Python from that particular serial, and he was taken that word and has been put the name of the language, that is Python language. Okay, then so there are many different kinds of features are there. There are many different kinds of features are there. While developing so this Python language, he was taken so many number of languages into consideration. So first of all functional programming aspects has been taken from C. All functional programming aspects. So how to write a function, and what are the actual, what exactly a function will be done when it is being execution, it is being under execution. Such kind of features has been taken from C, and all object-oriented programming features has been taken from C++, not from Java, from C++ only he was taken. And all scripting language. So we may be write some scripts also. All scripting language features have been taken from Perl and Shell. Shell in the sense Unix programming, Unix shell scripting program. So something is there for you. It may be comes to you in your 3.1. So from Perl and Shell scripting, he was taking all shell scripting features. And all modular programming has been taken from so Modular 3. This is one more programming language, Modular 3. Of course, it is not used right now. People are not using this particular Modular 3 right now. But so from this particular Modular 3, he was taking so modular programming features. So look at this. C does not have any object-oriented. Scripting is not there about C. Modular programming is not there with C. Okay. And C++ is so enhancement of C. So it does have functional programming and object programming, but scripting cannot be done. Modular so cannot be done in C++. And the Perl and the Shell, so it doesn't support the functional programming and object-oriented programming. It could be so write some kind of script. The script will be executed in a so top-down fashion, and it could be performed some kind of operations. Okay, so. And modular programming could be used to develop many number of modules, such as procedures, functions, packages, something like many number of things have been developed by modular. And all these things will be collectively so taken into consideration by Gaudio von Rossum, and has been prepared Python. So that is why so Python. Python does have as much as many number of features such as all these. But the statements or the instructions which are used to write in Python will be taken from so C and ABC language. So he is a very good fan for Dennis Ritchie and Ken Thompson. These are the two pioneers for computer science. Dennis Ritchie was introduced to the C programming language. And Ken Thompson was introduced to this particular ABC language. So from these two, he was inspired to write the syntaxes for Python from C and ABC languages. So this is the information regarding to features, where exactly the features has been taken. We will discuss what are the features, different kinds of features, but all those features were included to your Python programming language from different kinds of languages here. Okay, and then followed by where you can use this Python, in which area, what is the area so you are supposed to use this particular Python. Python is nowadays Python is used anywhere else. You could use anywhere else. So such as desktop applications, such as so web applications, such as so database applications. Wanted to develop any database application, you can use Python and it could be done. Such as network programming, any router kind of so there are some routers, you could have some Wi-Fi router will be there with you. So within that router, manufacture kind of programming could be there. That programming could also be done by using Python. And then you can develop some games. You could able to develop games by using this particular Python. And you can also develop data analysis applications. Nowadays, we are with Corona and COVID-19. And for COVID-19, so Arogya Setu was created by Government of India. Government of India has created Arogya Setu. And the people whomever download and store that particular Arogya Setu by using Bluetooth proximity, it could be identified when any two people will be come closer. If any person will be infected, then immediately it will be so give some sign to you that the person who is met with will be having this COVID-19, something like that. Some small sign will be given here, given there, and that information is being maintained by NIC, National Information Center, NIC, that is called as NIC. The complete information regarding to COVID using Arogya Setu will be maintained within the database. The database is called as NIC. So from NIC, you have been taking some data and it could be analyzed where exactly the concentration of COVID will be, in which area the concentration of COVID will be. Such kind of applications could also be done. So by using Python here. And Python could also be used in machine learning in the sense, so because you are a human being, you could learn at your own. But a machine could be always follows the instructions what you have to provide. So those instructions must be given in a proper way that the machine could also be learned. As and when you have to sense any kind of machine, then it immediately gives you some information that you maybe have something. Okay, something like Arogya Setu, something like some other applications which are available in the market. So such kind of machine learning applications could also be developed by using Python. And so artificial intelligence kind of applications could also be so developed by using Python. And very, very importantly, Python was used IoT, okay, Internet of Things. So probably you people have watching the TV continuously. Probably in the last summer, Mahesh Babu has come one particular ad. That ad is, so I will stop, I will switch off my AC right away from here. So while sending one small SMS to the AC, immediately my AC will be get switched off. Otherwise, if you would send one small SMS to the AC, then it will be immediately switch on, something like that. So those operations, those applications will be IoT applications. Okay, and I will forward one particular so video to you to know what is IoT properly. So soon after completion of this one, I'll send you one video. So please observe that particular video or watch that particular video, how IoT could be works. So these are not only these, what I have listed here, not only this, you maybe have as many number of so applications, area of applications you could use this particular Python. Okay, so being as a learner, you could also use Python as first and foremost language which is used to learn by the so learners or students. So these are the area. And versions of Python already I have discussed, but one more time would like to take this one here. So most IT giants in the sense Google, Microsoft, and YouTube, many other so companies are there. So Google is internally using Python for search engine. Google is basically, it is a search engine. So wanted to search for anything, obviously you have to write some kind of code. That code will be written, rewritten, not exactly. So initially it was not written by Google, Python, and it was written by some other language, but it was migrated to use this particular Python. And YouTube also, so manipulating that particular videos and data, so YouTube also used Python. And NASA, so very powerful in terms of National Aeronautic Space, something like that. It is a very powerful area. And the New York Stock Exchange also used this particular Python for development, their application developments. And Microsoft, IBM, Yahoo, and many other MNCs are used this Python for developing their applications. Okay, Microsoft Azure, cloud-based so application is there, that is also developed by using Python only. Okay, like that, we have many companies have used this particular Python. And what are the current versions which are available with us? Current versions will be Python 3.8.5. It is the current version which is available. And Python 2.7.18. So as we said, as we know, in the first slide itself, as we know that Python has two versions, that is Python 3 and Python 2. So Python 3 will be this version right now, and Python 2 will be this version right now. And Python 3 does not provide any compatibility, backward compatibility of Python 2. Actually, Python 2 was introduced first, the later Python 3 was introduced. And the Python 2 programs cannot be executed in Python 3. Okay, so normally if you create any lower version, let me say version number 0, if you create one particular application programming, version number 0 will be generated by you at some X time, and version number 2.0 will be generated in Y time, in the sense it has been generated, let me consider in 2000 it has been generated to the public, and in 2010 2.0 has been generated to public, in the sense. So normally whatever the commands which are available within this particular 1.0 must also be executed in 2.0. this is the general procedure actually. But Python doesn't have such kind of backward compatibility. So Python 2 programs cannot be worked. Maybe, but most of the Python 2 programs cannot be worked with Python 3. So that is what the meaning here. Yes, there is no guarantee that Python 2 programs will be run on Python 3. Okay, that is what you need to consider. That is the meaning of backward compatibility. Backward compatibility does means that is the meaning. And if you want to install the Python, you may be visit. So this particular python.org, let me open for you for a while. So python.org, yes, it is the Python. So if within this one, you please visit this particular thing, downloads. So here you have a huge number of downloads are there here. So look at this, these are the different kinds of downloads which are available. And you could observe, so Python 3.8.5, which was released in July 20, 2020. You can download this one, and you can install this one. And if you want to install with Python 2.7, so this is the latest version of Python 2.7. It is also April 2020, it has been released. And you can install any one of these. As per your requirement, you have to install. But our class and our programs, everything will be done by using Python 3.0 only. I mean Python 3, followed by any version, whatever the subversion it might be, Python 3 must be taken into consideration. And if you don't have any laptops with you, laptops are not there with you, so you please install, let me show you. So cell phones, you please install code compiler. So it could be seems like this code compiler. And if you open this particular code compiler, obviously you could have as many number of programming language support will be there. You can open this one, and here you could go ahead change language, something like this. So if you click on this one, tap on this one, it will be open. Since it is a computer, it could be take some time. So yes, you could see as much as many number of programming languages will be get supported here. So you could select, so Python 3.0. Okay, you could select Python 3.0. Obviously, you could able to write your programs in Python 3.0. Okay, so this is for cell phone, and this is for the system, laptop or desktop, any one of these. Okay, you could select something like this. It's actually MySQL. I'd like to change from the MySQL to. It will take some time. Okay, you please check out this one. So like this, you can install your Python into your system or your cell phone also. And you may be select this particular thing, as I said just before, you may be select Python 3.8.5. Okay, and if you want to write the first program, very simple program, I want to print, so hello world. So look at this, I want to print this particular program. So in Python, if you want to print this particular data into your using your Python, let us compare how could you write this particular program using C++ and Python. What are the number of steps or number of instructions you are supposed to write in each and every language? You are well versed with the C, so look at this. This is the way to write your Hello World program in C here. You must include. So look at this. You must include stdio.h, and you must write one main program and open brace, print Hello World and closed brace. So look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Totally 4 to 5 lines must be written by you. Whereas if you take the same operation in C++, look at this. In C++, you may be right. I'm talking about this C++ in terms of object orientation only. Of course, the same program, whatever the program you have written here, that could also work here. But I'm talking about an object orientation program kind of thing. So you have to include IO stream. And you have to create a particular class, and the class must be having one method. That method is hello, and you have to produce that particular output, something like this. After that, in your main program, you have to create one object for that particular class. My object name is hello world. Actually, class name is hello world here. This hello world will be created with one object, that is h. It may be called h.hello. h.hello will be called, obviously, so C++ will be generates hello world output to the screen. Okay, if you want to generate output for hello world in terms of object orientation, you must write this many number of lines. Okay, in terms of C, you must learn this many number of lines. But in Python 3.0, look at the way of writing, just one line, only one line, print hello world, things are over. Okay, no function initiation, no inclusions, no imports, nothing at all. No class will be defined and nothing will be taken into consideration. Just you have to write only one statement which will be able to print so your hello world. So that is the basic difference between these three. Not exactly, you know C programming language perfectly because you people have written many programs in C, and you are going to learn C++. That is why I have taken these two. Otherwise, I may be discussed with Java also, because you people doesn't know as per the curriculum. I don't know whether you may be learn Java programming language in somewhere else. I don't know that. But as per the BTEC curriculum, as far as this particular 2.1 is concerned, you have learned C programming, and you are in parallel with the Python, you are also learning C++. So that is why I make some kind of comparative study in between these three. Okay, so this is as simple as that. Okay, Python language is as simple as that. And let me show you one more. Wanted to print so sum of two numbers, sum of two integers. For example, look at this. In C, you have to write something like this. You have to declare for the variable something like this. Integer A will be, of course, I have taken in directly assign the values here. You may be take input also, there is no problem. So, however, you could see this particular declaration and another variable also declared, and you have to use this particular add. Of course, add must be used, and you have to print like this. Similarly, in the previous explanation, here also we have to include something, and you need to write a particular main program, something like this. And in C++, so here also I wrote this particular program based on the object orientation only. You have create one particular class here. One particular class will be created, and take some kind of variables here. In one method, you have create some number of variables, and you have to add them, and you have to so print them. After class creation is gets over, that class will be so does have one instance or one object must be created here. This object must be called this add function. So these many lines must be written for adding just simple two numbers. Okay, 10 and 20 for adding these two. So you may be write this particular simple. Whereas simple addition, you may be write this many number of statements. Whereas in Python, let us assume what is the statements we are included here. Just three statements are required. Okay, I have missed one particular statement here. That is C equal to, so A plus B. A plus B has missed here, sorry for that. So four statements are required. No need to create any function, something like this here. No need to create any class, something like this in C++. You just straight away take value of A, value of B, and add them, and have to print them. Okay? So as simple as that. In this way, you can write your programs. So I have shown you two examples. One is printing hello world, and second one is addition of two numbers. In C or C++, some other languages, you have to initiate, you have to import something or include something, you have to initiate a function, or you have to initiate a class, and the class must be created an object, and after creation of that particular object, you have to call the function. Okay, many other operations could be done using C, C++, Java. Whereas in Python, so look at this, mathematics teacher will be says that how to add two numbers in the sense, take value for A, take value for B, add those and print them. This is the simple steps which we have to given, which a mathematics teacher will be given. So what the mathematics teacher has given, same thing was implemented here in Python. So that is why Python is a pretty much simple language to learn. Okay. So I haven't developed this particular features still. So I will take these features by tomorrow, because only one particular feature was implemented, not more than. Actually, we do have 11 features are available for Python. We will complete these things by tomorrow. Okay, let me implement one particular program. So look at this, you have many. Yeah, so Python 3. This is the Python 3. Just one moment. Yes, it was selected. And one moment. Let us write a small program. So I'm trying to write in terms of the cell phone only. So already print hello world already is there. Just you have to apply for run. So you could see the output here. So no input is there for me. No input is there, and run. It will take some time because third party software has installed into my system. So that is why it would take some time. So in your cell phone, it could be executed very fastly. Don't worry about this. Okay, hello world. Let me go ahead with code and let me eliminate this one. Okay. Okay, look at this. Let me take A will be equal to some 10. A is equal to. Oh, we'll be taking a huge amount of time. taking a huge amount of time to write this one. Let me open the Jupiter, because Jupiter is one of the most equality is not typing here. Okay, your cell phone could be able to type everything. There is no problem at all. But here, I don't know why equality is not typing here. However, let me open this particular Jupiter for a while. Whether it is opened or not. Yeah. One moment, please. Yeah, online Python compilers could also be available. You could write our programs here. There is no problem. Yes, here you could see. I don't know why it is not supporting. Okay. So A will be equal to some 10. B will be equal to 20, and C will be equal to A plus B. Print. So the addition. ADDITION. Addition is followed by comma C. Run this particular program. You could see simply. You may be right. Your program with the simple. As such, as the mathematical teacher has been giving you. So same kind of statements will be implemented here, then you could get output something like this. Okay, in this way, you could write your programs. You could write anything here, okay? So that is the basic differences between these things here. So here, you could able to write, hello world, by using C, many number of lines, C++, huge number of lines, whereas Python, single line. Okay, adding up two different numbers. So using C, C++, huge number of lines will be written, whereas it could be written very less in numbers. Okay, so that is the importance. Okay, importance of this Python. It's very pretty simple, and you are expected to learn this one in a proper way. So happy learning regarding to this one. Okay. So I'll close this one for today. And tomorrow we shall continue. Yeah. Thank you. If you have any questions, then you please, yes. Jafar, tell me. Time is running out. Tell me, Jafar.